Here we're given four reactions, and we're asked which of these reactions is delta E larger than delta H. So delta E is also used in many textbooks as delta U for internal energy. Now delta H is defined as delta E plus delta PV. If we're asking when is delta E greater than delta H, that's the same thing as asking when is delta PV less than zero. In other words, we're adding this negative number to delta E, so we're going to get delta H smaller than delta E. So delta PV, only volume changes are going to be very significant, are gases. So if we looked at ideal gas law, so if we're doing this at constant temperature, making the comparison at given temperature and pressure for the reaction, that means for rich reactions, is delta N less than zero. And keep in mind, this is delta N in the gas phase. Let's look at D. Number of moles increases, so that's not one. For C, the number of moles is the same. For B, we have 6 moles of gas on the left side and 3 moles of gas on the right side because this is a liquid. So this is one of the reactions where delta N is less than zero. And then for A, we have 3 moles of gas on the left side, 2 moles of gas on the right side. This is also one of the reactions. So our answers are A and B, or delta E, the internal energy change is going to be larger than delta H, the enthalpy change.